Children, I hope you very well understand both the chapters, chapter 1 and chapter 2. Now we will continue with chapter 3, that is data handling. Yesterday I gave you a brief introduction of data handling. Now we will continue about that chapter, that is data handling. Now students, we have to do exercise 3.1. Yesterday we have done few questions related to exercise 3.1. The question based upon mean, the tabular form of the numbers and range and so on. Now I have selected few questions for you related to mean and the range as well. Now first question from the exercise 3.1 is, a cricketer score the following runs in 8 innings and the runs are 58, 76, 40, 35, 46, 45, 0 and 100. Now these are the runs in the 8 innings. Alright. Now find out the mean score of these runs. Now the data can be given in the form of the marks or data can be given in the form of the runs or any other data can be given. But all are the runs of the innings. So, answer is, let us try the answer, scores of the runs in 8 innings, how many score is given, how many runs are given, 58, 76, 40, 35, 46, 45, 0 and 100. These are the runs given in the 8 innings. Alright, now the mean of these runs is, you have to use the formula of mean. The formula is sum of all observation divided by number of observation. Here we can write sum of all the runs. Observation are here used by the runs. These all are the runs. Not like that, that some numbers are marks, some are weight and some are run. No, the quality of all the digits are similar. That is all are runs. Now sum of all the runs divided by number of innings. How many innings are played to get the runs? So first of all, sum of runs. We have to add all the given runs. That is 58 plus 76 plus 40 plus 35 plus 46 plus 45 plus 0 and plus 100 divided by 8, because 8 we have to count these number. How many innings are given? 8 are given na? Or you can count these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The frequency of given number, frequency means how many numbers are given, how many innings are given actually. How many innings are given? That is 8. So the sum total of all these numbers is equal to 400. This is the numerator of the mean and denominator is number of innings divided by 8. When 400 is divided by 8, we get answer is 50. Okay, I thought you understand how we can find out the mean. Mean of anything else, either of the marks or of the runs, anything else. You have to use the same formula, sum of all observations. Observation may be marks, you have to write marks. Observation are runs, you must write runs. Or any observation, suppose the weight of the students are given, the sum of the weight of all the students, like that. So you have to write sum of all observation or you must write sum of all runs in this case. Now next question is, the marks out of 100 means the marks of the students are given, but those marks are out of 100. The total marks are 100 obtained by a group of students in a science test are 85, 76, 90, 85, 39, 48, 56, 95, 81 and 75. Now you can see in these marks, if the marks are given out of 100. 85 repeated 2 times. Now marks can be repeated for the students. Now maybe first student get 85 marks. Then fourth student also get 85 marks. That doesn't matter. The data can be repeated. The data can be repeated in this also, because the number of runs a cricketer made in the innings are not important to be equal. They may be equal. Alright. So the marks also could be equal. That doesn't matter. If the 85 come once, then 85 comes two times, three times, or how many times? Any number can be repeated, because these are the marks given out of 100. These are only the observations given in the form of the marks. Now, what we have to find out from these observations? First, the highest and the lowest marks. Our first question is, you have to find out, observe these observations. Observe, first of all, collect the data, then observe the data, then present the data. Presentation means you have to present the highest marks of the students, then present the lowest marks the student get. How many marks are the lowest marks? Alright, next we have to find out the range of the marks. For finding the range of the marks, we must use the highest and the lowest marks. Next, the third point is, find the mean of the marks. Here we can write mean of the marks as well. Now, let us start the answer. First of all, you can also write in the answer that the number of, that the marks of the students given are. First, you must write the marks, then start with the answer. Now, the first answer is the highest marks. How many marks are the highest? See, 85, 76, which number is the highest? 90. When 90 come, now 90 is greater than these two terms. Now you must observe the more than 90 marks. Because 90 comes, and 90 is greater than 85 and 76. So leave all those marks which are start from 80 or 70. 85, 39, no, 48, 56, no. 95, we have to neglect these marks, because already we get 90 marks. Now we have to observe more than 90 are happen or not. More than 90 are 95 marks. Or you can also write these observation in the ascending or descending order. In that way, you also, observation is easy. Observe, if you write these in the descending or the ascending, in which we have to write the smallest, then greater, then greater. You can write these numbers in an order also, either in ascending or in descending. So your observation is little bit easy. As we search for the highest marks, then you get easily the highest marks. Alright, now the highest marks in this case are the 95. So our first answer is highest marks is equal to 95. Now what are the lowest marks? See, from this side, highest marks in the range of the 90, 80, 70. Now 70 is less than 80, 76 is less than 85. Come towards forward, 39. Now observe, the less than 39 are the marks or not? No, there are no marks less than 39. So lowest marks are the 39 marks out of 100. So one student get at least lowest marks, that is 39 marks. किसी भी स्टूडेंट के 39 से कम मार्क्स नहीं है एंड 95 से ज्यादा मार्क्स नहीं है. इफ यू राइट ऑल दिस नंबर इन द असेंडिंग ऑर्डर ना, देन और डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर, देन इट इज इजी टू ऑब्जर्व द लोएस्ट एंड द हाईएस्ट मार्क्स. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट दीज ऑब्जर्वेशन सो दैट देर इज नो एरर इन द कैलकुलेशन. ऑलराइट, नाउ नेक्स्ट इज द रेंज ऑफ द मार्क्स. What is the formula for range of the marks? Highest marks minus lowest marks. What are the highest marks? As we have already observed from these observations, 95. Next, lowest marks, 39. Now, the range is highest marks minus lowest marks. So, 95 minus 39. What is the answer? 56. This is the range of the marks. Range means, क्या होता है range का मतलब? कि approximately जो marks हैं, some marks are less than 56 and some marks are greater than 56. You get na 1 marks is 56 also. So range means you have to write in between these marks, approximately these marks. Alright, so we get 3 answers. First, highest marks 95, lowest marks 39, and range highest minus lowest marks, that is 56. Next, mean marks. Third, we have to find out the mean of the marks. Alright, basically these 3 things you have to find out in the exercise of 3.1 in all the questions. Mean means, again, sum of all the observation, or you can write sum of all the marks obtained divided by number of students. Sum of all the marks obtained divided by number of how many students get the marks, or how many students give the science test. Alright. So, first of all, sum of all the marks means you have to add all the given marks. Start from 85 plus 76 plus 19 plus 85 plus 39 plus 48 plus 56 plus 95 plus 81 plus 75. You have to add all these. You must understand that the calculation must be correct here. Otherwise, your whole answer is wrong. The addition must be correct. You must add in a correct way so that your answer or your mean must be correct. So, the total sum of these numbers is, these marks are 730, and divided by how many students there we have. Count the students, 1, 2, you have just count how many numbers are used, how many marks are used. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 students give the science test, so the number of students are 10. So, the formula is sum of all the marks obtained divided by number of students. So, result is 730 divided by 10. The result 10, 0 can be cancelled out from the numerator as well as from the denominator. And mean marks are 73. Alright, I thought you very well understand the questions related to from these two examples, the highest observation and the lowest observation and the range. And next are the mean, which we have find out first of all for the runs. And in this case, mean find out for the marks. The formula is same, just the use is different. Here we have to use the mean of the runs, sum of all the runs. Here we are finding the mean of the marks, that is sum of all marks. Now you can observe also the mean is 73. Now 73 are the marks in between these numbers, that is approximately few numbers are more than 73 and few numbers are less than 73. Alright, next question I have selected for you is the rainfall in millimeters in a city on 7 days. The observation given to you or the data given to you is the how much rainfall is happened in a city for 7 days of a certain week. Was recorded. 7 days in a week, you know, and how many, what are the days? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. 7 days we have selected of a week, and the rainfall given to you is on Monday there is a 0.0 millimeter rainfall. Tuesday 12.2 mm. Wednesday 2.1 mm. Thursday 0.0 mm rainfall is happened. Friday 20.5, Saturday 5.5, and on Sunday how much? 1.0 mm rainfall happened. Alright. Now this is the range of the this is the rainfall actually given in the form of the data. 4 days are given of a week. Now in this question we have three question more attached with this. This is the only data given. The questions used in this you can see from the book. I have not written the whole question because that is so much lengthy to write now, because that is so much spacious. But the questions are similar for all the questions. In question 3, we have to find out again the highest and the lowest. And the highest and lowest is rainfall. Alright, next we have to find out the range. And next we have to find out the mean. As we have find out in this second question, similarly we have to find out everything in the question number 3. So first of all, you observe the data that total days are 7, rainfall are given. You have to use these two observations to find out your answers. So first answer is the maximum rainfall we have to find out. What is the maximum rainfall? You can see, you can compare the decimal numbers, na, as we have already done decimal chapter. So you can compare the decimal number according to their place value as well. 0.0, 12.2, 2.1, 0.0 and 20.5, 5.5, 1.0. Out of all these 7 observations, which is greater? Now you can see that 20.5, because 2 is at the which place? 10th place. And 10th place, and 10th place we have 2. Nowhere in other observation, 10th place is filled by 2. So the maximum rainfall happened on Friday. And what is the rainfall happened? 20.5 mm. So maximum rainfall is 20.5 mm on Friday. What is the minimum rainfall for the week? Minimum rainfall is 0.0 on Monday as well as on Thursday. So minimum rainfall is 0.0 mm on Thursday, and you also write on Monday as well. Alright, I have written for Thursday. You can also write also for Monday and Thursday. You must write for Monday and Thursday, both the days. If the days are to be written down, if the question is given, then on which day the minimum rainfall? Alright, on which day? Monday and Thursday. And on which day the rainfall is maximum? On Friday, the rainfall is maximum. Now, the second question is, find the range of the rainfall. Range is maximum rainfall minus minimum rainfall. What is maximum rainfall? 20.5 mm. And what is the minimum rainfall? 0.0 mm. So the range, that is the difference of these two, is 20.5 mm. This is the range of the rainfall. Next, mean rainfall. Again, the same thing which we have already done in this question. Sum of observations, or here we can write sum of rainfalls. You must understand the difference between writing the formula, right? Formula is same. Sum of all the runs, sum of all the marks, if marks are given. If runs are given, then sum of all the runs. If the rainfall happened, then sum of all the rainfalls. Alright, and in the denominator, we have write number of days. In this case, number of innings. In the second question, number of students. So, you must observe what kind of data is given. The rainfall give us the numerator of the mean, and the days total given the denominator of the mean. So, sum of rainfalls. What are the rainfall? 0.0 plus 12.2 plus 2.1 plus 0.0 plus 20.5 plus 5.5 plus 1.0. Now when you add the decimal number, you must add according to their place values. That is 10th decimal number, 10th place decimal number added to 10th place, 1's place added to 1's place, and 10th place added to 10th place. Now how many days the observation is given? For 7 days the observation is given, for 7 days of a week. Now after adding all the rainfalls in mm, the result is 41.3 mm divided by 7. This is the total of all these rainfalls. When we divide 7 to 41.3, we get 5.9. You can also divide by using the fractional part, that is, remove this decimal, that is divided by 10, then 7 divide 413, and then you place a decimal. Alright, you can you just simple divide 413 by 7, then place the decimal. So we get 5.9 mm average or mean rainfall happen in 7 days. And 5.9 is the range, is the average of these observations are given. Because some rainfalls like 0.0 or 2.1 or 5.5 are less than 5.9 and some are greater than 5.9. Now, the third question related to this type of question is, for how many days the rainfall is less than the mean rainfall. Means jo third question hai, that told that kaun kaun se din ya kitne din, how many days rainfall jo hua wo mean rainfall se less tha. Alright, so you have to observe the mean rainfall and the given rainfalls. On which day the rainfall is less than 5.9 mm. On Monday 0.0, which is less than 5.9. Okay, next 12.2 is the greater na. 2.1 is less than, 0.0 is less, 5.5 is also less than 5.9, and 1.0 is also less than 5.9. So this is the question based upon the comparison of the decimal numbers. So we can say the number of days on which the rainfall less than the mean rainfall, jab mean rainfall se kam rainfall hua, that are 5 days. Which 5 days? Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday and Sunday. These 5 days are given for the rainfall which is less than the mean rainfall. Similarly, we can find out the number of days on which rainfall is greater than mean rainfall. On which days? That is Tuesday, the rainfall is greater than mean rainfall. On Friday as well, the rainfall is greater than mean rainfall. So on these, based on these observations, there are so many questions you can find out and you can write the answers for those questions. So I thought you understand how we can find out the maximum or minimum or the range or mean and the some other kind of observation, some other kind of question based upon the observation. Again and again, the previous chapters like decimal are also used in this question, but this calculation must be correct. The addition must be correct because the mean is totally based upon the addition. Alright, now students, you must complete your exercise 3.1 because few questions we have done yesterday and few questions I have done for you today. Now you complete the exercise 3.1 related to data handling, and the exercise is totally based upon mean, range, maximum and minimum. So you can easily do all the questions.